And until next time, this has been another episode of the Typewriter video series. You guys, you have yourselves a great day. Bye-bye. Okay, that was a pretty good episode, huh? Let's see, what am I going to do now? Well, I think I'm going to tune into my shortwave radio here. What? Zombies? Here? Coming down the street? Uh-oh. You know what? I better get ready. Oh, what do I... Okay, I have to get my bug-out bag. Okay, my bug-out bag. What do I need? Compass. I got my grandpa's old World War I compass. I'll need that. Granola bar. Yep, check. Gotta have some food. A little first aid kit, right? Yeah, first aid kit. Yeah, you can't... You have to go out... 45, check. Zombies. Riot gun, check. Let's see, what else do I need? Pocket dictionary. Yeah, pocket dictionary, fountain pen. We're gonna get some fountain pen ink, correction tape, notebook, and, oh yeah, typewriter bug out bag. Well, this was just a make-believe zombie apocalypse, but if it had been a real zombie apocalypse and you decided you needed something to write with while you were out running from the zombies or hunting zombies down, you might want to have a typewriter bug-out bag. So in the survivalist culture here in America, there is this idea of the bug-out bag, and if you do a... Wikipedia search, it tells us that the bug out bag might have originated back in the Korean War era. The idea of a soldier having everything he needs at a moment's notice in one bag or satchel or whatever, and you just grab it and go. It has food, water, whatever provisions you need for the kind of thing you're doing. But the modern revival of the survivalist thing in America, I think people have kind of adopted that philosophy of the bug-out bag, something you can just, it's already pre-prepared, you just grab and go for when the zombies are heading in through the back kitchen window. If you're a typical typewriter collector, you might have your typewriter stored away in a closet somewhere, or underneath the bed, or down in the basement or the garage somewhere. Not necessarily easy to get to, but there are times when you might want to be spontaneous with your creativity, spontaneous with your writing, and you might want to take a typewriter out with you wherever you go, just in case you feel creative, you want to stop off someplace, coffee shop, or maybe out at the park on a bench, someplace like that to type and get some creative writing in. One of the options, of course, is to leave a typewriter in the trunk of your car. But if you live in a part of the world where you have severe temperature extremes between winter and summer, especially in the winter, you may not want to leave your typewriter out in the freezing cold, because a lot of those lubricants are going to start congealing, and the performance of the machine might very well suffer. So you kind of want to keep your typewriter in some more normal temperature range. On the other hand, you also want to have a portable typewriter if you want to be able to go out quickly and write somewhere. So you're not going to want to have a medium-sized typewriter or an electric typewriter or something like that. You want a little portable typewriter. Now, I have in my collection a number of portable typewriters, any one of which it would be perfect. I think the smallest typewriter in my collection for quick grab-and-go writing is my little Hermes Rocket, but because of its age and there is this little issue of the linkage or the lever that does the carriage release, the carriage release lever allowing you to slide the carriage, that little thing gets bent slightly. It gets bent fairly easy because the metal is soft, and then the escapement gear alignment with the rack gear goes out and it starts skipping. And so I've kind of decided that that machine is a little bit delicate, and I don't use it as much for that purpose. So I do have a number of other portable typewriters, and the current portable typewriter that I'm kind of in in love with is the most recent portable, which was this Olympia SF. And like a lot of my other portables, like the Brother typewriters and even the Olivetti letterers that I used to have, they all fit pretty well in this shoulder bag, right? It's a shoulder bag. It has a nice sturdy strap that'll go around your shoulders, bandolero style. And what I like to carry in the bag, along with the typewriter, of course, is a pack of paper. Obviously, you got to have something to write with. I use this Mead multi-purpose typing paper, and I have a correction cartridge. I also take a little electronic pocket dictionary, which you saw me using in the little acting sequence earlier. So this is kind of my typewriter bug out bag. I keep the portable typewriter in this shoulder bag with the paper, correction tape, and dictionary, and I keep it someplace convenient, like here in my office. I keep it next to the sofa, love seat, couch thingy there. Just, it's out of the way. You can't really see it from the door, so it's not, it doesn't look like clutter, because she who must be obeyed doesn't like clutter. But it's in the back there in the corner, so you can't really see it very easily, but it's easy to grab and go. And I find this is a real convenient way to help foster more typewriter use and more creativity. When you're going to go out and just drive around, maybe you have some errands to run, and maybe you might feel kind of open-ended, like, oh, I have some time, I might go do something, grab that typewriter bag and go out with it. Stick it in your car and you'll have it with you wherever you want to go. Now, one of the things about this whole idea of having a bug out bag with a typewriter in it and going out someplace and typing is there's no rules. So when I said early on, for me, I'd rather have an ultra portable and maybe not a medium-sized typewriter, well, that may not be the case for you, and you might want to take something like this Smith Corona Silent Super, which I can open up the lid. Smith Corona Silent Super, it's a pretty nifty little machine, and you know, medium size, not extra big. It has a case with a handle that's rugged, and you can carry it from your car to across a parking lot, to a coffee shop, a park, or wherever. And let me show you one of the cool things about these typewriters that are in these hard cases. First of all, what I do is I like to carry a correction tape cartridge, and I find that if you stick it right down in the segment, it's a good place to store your correction tape. And then a small pack of paper, it doesn't have to be too much, but oftentimes on these kind of typewriters, you can just lay the pack of paper over the top of the machine and it'll close down just fine and store. And so you have your paper and your correction tape already in the case, ready to go. And so if you're doing a bug out bag, so to speak, with a medium-sized typewriter like this in a hard case, the case itself becomes the bug-out bag. You have your handle and it's just ready to grab and go. I think for me, the first time I was ever inspired to think about taking a typewriter out somewhere and using it outside of the house was on Richard Polt's website. He has on the front page of his website a link to articles about how other people use typewriters, and there is this essay written by BJ Best, and it's titled Machine Quest Ghost River. And the article is wonderful, and it's illustrated by a wonderful black and white photograph of a stream with a portable camping chair and a folding camping table sitting in the water of the stream with a typewriter sitting atop the table. And the article is about the pleasures of going on a camping trip and taking a manual typewriter with you. And that was probably the first time I'd really been exposed to this concept that portable typewriters are genuinely portable, hence the name. And therefore, we have permission from the manufacturer by default to take the typewriter out of the office, out of the house, and somewhere else. And so I would encourage you to take your machine on that writing quest, wherever it is, wherever the quest leads you to, wherever the creative muse inspires you, you have to have the typewriter with you in order to really be able to use it as a writing tool. And so you need to have that typewriter ready to go. Have it in a bug out bag, or if it's one of the hard case typewriters with a handle, that's your bug out bag. But have the typewriter ready with paper and correction tape and go out, take it, and write. Until next time, this is Joe Van Cleve, and I think I'm going to take my bug out bag and go out and write today. I'll see you guys later.